What's clear across all the studies that have been published to date is that taking dietary collagen, either before or after you do your exercise, actually improves your exercise performance. And we did a study just across here with the UC Davis football team where we saw that when we had them do their heavy strength training, if they took a collagen supplement afterwards, they actually found that they had better performance measures. So they could jump faster and they could move quicker than if they took a placebo control. Collagen is not a good protein. It's not complete because it lacks a certain amino acids. Whey protein is a very high quality protein. And so what we did is we combined them because collagen has more things that it are going to be enriched in our tendons and ligaments. When we combined the whey protein and the dietary collagen, we actually saw measures of increased synthesis of the connective tissue in our skeletal muscle. So we actually took muscle biopsies and we used the muscle tissue that we got to show that we could get more connective tissue protein synthesis when we supplemented with whey and collagen together. If you go to the supermarket and you get a gelatin from the cooking aisle, or if you get a hydrolyzed collagen from the supplement aisle, they work the same in our body. The only thing that we really are concerned with is that the gelatins themselves, a lot of times they come from bones. And when we've got bones from large animals or mammals just in general, that's where animals store their heavy metals. So that's not necessarily good because that can be high in heavy metals like lead and other, you know, more detrimental heavy metals. So all we tell people is that if you are looking to do a dietary collagen, that you look to see that it comes from a skin source, so pelts of say pork or beef, or you get a fish type of collagen because the fish don't have the same issue where they're storing their heavy metals in their bones.